Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. And today I'm just going to go do a short review of the 80 meter handle. As you can see, this is a standard radio. You can use lower sideband, CW, FSK, there's a bunch of different frequencies here. But we're just actually talking about the frequency range. The 80 meter, basically, amateurs within a range of 500 miles or 800 kilometers get on here during contests. The band is filled with the activity beginning before sunset and continuing throughout the day and night. The 80 meter band begins at 3.5 megahertz and goes up to 4 megahertz or 3,500 kilohertz. Now, most radios, this one too, has you can set frequencies and stuff, but we're just going to go, maybe we'll hear something. My antenna's not the best. This is a great radio, the TS-200 does, because it does HF, UHF and VHF. It really does. It's 144 and 440, so you can get satellites on this one. It's a nice radio, really nice radio for the price. That is the upper end of it, or the end of it. So 3.5 megahertz, it goes up to 4 megahertz. The upper part of the band, mostly used for voice, is often referred to as 75 meters, since the wavelength there is between 80 and 75 meters. Large physical size of antennas at this frequency, a quarter wave vertical for approximately 62 feet long and 20 meters high, and the difficulty of ensuring significant low-angle radiation from antennas to maximize the distance of hops are two of the most challenges facing amateurs wishing to communicate over long distances. Most amateurs interested in regional communication use low wire antennas such as dipoles, inverted D dipole antennas, or loop antennas on this band. Horizontally polarized antennas when close to the Earth produce predominantly high-angle radiation. High angles are used for near vertical incident sky wave and other short-distance propagations, but substantial distance can be still covered with a modest height antenna. 80 meters is plagued with a lot of noise, with a rural noise foreset by propagated noise from distant thunderstorms and man-made noise sources. Urban and suburban noise floor is often established by local noise, and is generally 10 to 20 decibels stronger than the typical rural noise. On 80 meters, nearly all areas of the world are subject to local weather-induced noises from thunderstorms. The ionosphere delayer also affects the 80 meters significantly by absorbing signals. During daylight, a station in the middle of the high altitude using 100 watts and a simple dipole can expect a maximum range of 200 miles, extending to a few thousand miles or more at night. So at night, the delayer becomes a little bit more active at night. The higher background noise on 80 meters, especially when combined with higher ionosphere absorption, causes stations with higher effective radiated power to be decided advantage in long-distance communication. With very high antennas or large vertically polarized arrays in full legal power, reliable worldwide communication occurs over darkness bands. Mobile operation is also possible on this band. Propagation, maximum usable frequency for long distance communications, dips below 3.5 megahertz anywhere on the planet. The main propagation barrier to long distance communication is heavy D layer absorption during the daytime, ensuring DX paths must be largely, although not entirely, in darkness at times. At higher latitudes, a noticeable skip zone sometimes appears in the band during darkness hours in midwinter. Frequency allocation, International Telecommunication Unit allocated the whole 500 kilohertz from 3.5 to 4 megahertz to amateurs in America, and 3.5 to 3.8 or 3.9 megahertz to amateurs in other parts of the world. However, amateurs outside America must share this useful piece of spectrum with other users. I have some specifications. Some allocations are as follows in megahertz. Argentina 3.5 to 3.75, Australia 3.5 to 3.75, United States 3.5 to 4, It's megahertz. Lower band edge, the lower edge of the 80 meters is predominantly CW emissions, with the lower 10 kilohertz, 35 to 3510, primarily used for long distance communications. Upper band, for Canadian and US amateurs with perfect transmitters, the highest usable frequency in the 80 meter band for lower sideband is 3,999 kilohertz, depending on the quality and condition of the radio, audio characteristics, and proper adjustments for the bulk of emissions on the lower sideband, typically 3,997 to 3,999.7. All sideband transceivers have third and fifth order products of significant level, typically 30 to 35 decibel below PEP for third order intermodulation. So, it's a pretty nice band, but that's the 80 meter amateur band. And thanks a lot, guys. I know you're just hearing a lot of noise, but this is really just talking about the lot. Thanks a lot.